हेलो डॉक्टर शेफाली अगेन फॉर एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ साइबर क्राइम्स. नाउ हियर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड द वीडियो एम्स फॉर हैविंग द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ साइबर क्राइम यूजिंग द टारगेट हार्म. अर्लियर वी हैव गॉन फॉर द क्लासिफिकेशन विथ टू अदर पर्सपेक्टिव्स. वन इज दैट इज हैविंग द यूसेज ऑफ द कंप्यूटर एंड द अदर वन इज द यूसेज ऑफ द टेक्नोलॉजी. Now to the destination, that is to whom the target or the harm is there, we can have here the classification. And of course there is another branch which goes for some investigation of the digital crime. Some experts are involved in some cell and those cell people are having some authorities to have some utility of law and enforcement. So how the work is carried out of the digital forensic cell, we can find it out. So in a way, if the classification is to be carried out for the cyber crime, of course with the third category, using the harm to the target, we may have the major category as if it is the harm to the individual, harm to the property, harm to the organization, harm to the or other crime against the society. And of course, these are talking about the destinations, but there are certain sources with which the harm can be carried out. And the major idea is from your social network group or Usenet news groups are there. So in what way those news groups may create certain crime and these are spreading some threat over the individual, parameter, what you are considering as if it is the target, we can find it out. So in such a way, if the first idea is to be considered, that is the cybercrime against individual, there are a number of ways in what way the person can get disturbed because of these cyber ideas. The first one is that nowadays all users are using some emails, and email spoofing is one of the category with which the person can get harm. Okay, some fake sources are there where fake mails can be received or fake mails can be generated. Most of the working over the cyber is concerned with the usage of the password. So if any password sniffing is there and if any phishing of the password may take place, that is caching of the passwords are there, which is having a term as the phish the password. So most of the times the financial data or some important information may get hacked. It can be carried out in various forms, such as if it is related to the voice phishing, then it can be called as the vishing is one of the term. It may be related to the SMS phishing, can be called as the smishing, or likewise it can have certain attacks, and definitely those attacks may also involve some social engineering attacks. There are certain spamming which may overflow the contents of your electronic devices. Sometimes it may create some electronic spams are there. One idea I should discuss about it is along with the cyber defamation, which is publishing some tarnishing information to harm the person or the individual. Some stalkings are there which will harass by monitoring the information, monitoring the observation, monitoring the deeds or the works or the even key loggers are there which will monitor the passwords. Some threat transmission may be carried out, some ID thefts are there, damage of data or even equipments are there. So it comes under the stalking. Some computer sabotage is there. I need to talk about this one, that disturbing the normal functioning through worms. So it may just go for usage of malwares. The malwares may be in terms of worms, viruses, logic bombs, or even trojans are there. Even those trojans are nowadays working with your mobile devices also. We may have a talk over this. Some pornographic offenses are there which will tarnish by some visual descriptions, or the wrong intentions are there to having some ugly images of the individual or the personalities are there. Of course, it will be carried out by password sniffing, and this can be carried out by some intrusion attacks are there. Some weak passwords may be guessed out, or some monitoring may be there for the observation and the recording of the names and the passwords of the information, and with which some logins into the network can be carried out. So I have given one slide here. Of course, we are aware with the idea that if my HTTP comes out or changed to the HTTPS, then it can be as the secure one. And some of the say packages, some of the softwares are available. For example, this is the result of Komodo verification engine, that is the VeriSign is there. Earlier it was free, but nowadays it is chargeable. So if the site is, whichever the site you are using, maybe yahoo.com is there, this site is authenticated. So for the authentication, it is giving me some green border for the website itself. Green border is the default one. You can have some different color also. That different color can be set down with the settings of that particular verification engine. Then we can have certain idea about the closed clock. So if it is the having some closed clock, then definitely you can have certain monetary transactions with the website. If it is not closed, then definitely it is not secure for the SSL transactions. So definitely you can have the check over such precautions. Some alarms are there, and those alarms to aware to the user. I was talking about the fake mails. So there is some official mail which is the deadfake.com, can be used for the understanding purpose or can be used by ethical users who are having some good intention, those who are white hackers, to check the idea of the how the deadfake uses or fake mails can be created. So we can have certain statistics that those many fake mails are created, or in particular hour these many fake mails are there. So most of the times you can find it out that there are certain links, and those links may attract the attentions of the users for certain usages. And if you, or even if user clicks down to that particular say link, then definitely some trojans may get inserted to have the stealing of the data itself. If we check out for the deadfake.com or some fake mails are say intended for the checking purpose, then you can find out that of course if the Gmail is used, as if it is the internet browser, then in that case for the Gmail, for sending the mail, you can find out to whom you want to send. That is, the source is definitely you person is there. So it is authenticated. Some CC, that is copy, can be carried out for your mail. But if it is from the deadfake.com, that is the fake mails are there, from whom and to whom the mail is to be sent, both fields are available. That is, from some third person to other third person, you can send some mails. So this can be carried out, some in between person, some man which is in the middle position can send or can reutilize this. And you can observe that there is no CC, that is, you are not able to copy that particular mail. So such type of the fake mails are there. You can say that it can come under in the email spoofing. And for the email spoofing, is any investigation is to be carried out, of course, with the some forensic analysis. Then there are certain provisions with which the experts can identify the IP addresses of the senders, or even who is the ex-mailer. It may be from the deadfake, can be understood. Some hops in the network can be found, where those hops will give the idea from where exactly the routing of the email is carried out. Some of the softwares are available, those softwares, or some sites are there. Those sites may give an indication that from where it is identified, maybe unknown location is there, or maybe routed to some IP address which is not exactly included in the source and the destination of the mail. Maybe it is from the Navi Mumbai, India, or maybe some that particular location is not at all impacted in the mail itself, but still this can be one of the hop or one of the destination which can be identified. So such investigation can be there, with which the trespassing can be carried out and can be identified who is the sender itself. Of course, it will require some sophisticated tools, maybe software tools, maybe hardware tools are there, and some expertise, some practice is required. And of course is required, what is that, what is the logic of the black hat users or the criminals, in what way they can move further to make a crime. So that is an important idea. Now there are certain softwares, as I said, that there is the check for the petco.com, whether this particular slide is authenticated or not. Should I go for having any transaction, monetary transaction for that particular website? So I can just check it out that with this rating icons. If it is a safe one, it gives me that, okay, it's a safe one. Then it is, if it is I need to have certain caution or certain warning is there, then definitely I need to have certain message or I need to have certain checks for this one. This is actually the earlier case what I have checked out with the particular site. But possibly by now, when we are watching this particular video, the status might have changed. So you may have certain official legitimate websites are there which gives you, which helps you to have the check for the say authenticated usages in your cyber crime scenarios. I may say that everything is checked over, the sniffing of your password or phishing of your password. Many of the times your passwords are weak and guessable. But if any password which is in the hard form, which are the CMOS passwords, say in such cases, how to break the device, how to crack the device is the major hurdle in front of the criminals. But there are again methods to break the CMOS passwords. For example, if any lithium battery is there which is having some 3 volt inside, if a criminal tries to remove those batteries, then most of the times it is said that 70% of the times the bypassing of the password is carried out for booting of the system. Or even if the jumper settings are changed, normally those are having some connection with the 1 and 2, and if these are changed through 2 to 3, then definitely these will make the bypassing of the password. So this may have some threatful acts to break the system. Even some say precautionary passwords are there, and those precautionary passwords may get broken down by the criminal people itself. So we should be aware of all those situations. As I am talking about some of the say helpful softwares, for example, there is another one which may help to break the system password, because most of the times in Windows the passwords are stored in the SAM file and those are encrypted one. But if the particular system is booted from the CD itself, then definitely those CD, those bootable, after having the bootability, the SAM files are readable. So all passwords are made open to the user or to the criminal itself. So we need to have certain precautions over this one. Whenever we talk about, that is the cybercrime against property. So what is the property? What exactly is the your valuable thing? So one of the thing is that your cards, with which you have money cards, those money cards may be in your debit card from, or maybe in your credit card from, or even some smart cards are there which may store some important information. So those frauds can happen. Of course, those can happen because of some phishing, some passwords are getting opened up, some application layer attacks are there. Even we are having some valuable things in terms of the intellectual property. So even some software piracy is there, some theft of the programs are there, computer programs are there, or even some copyright violations or trademark violations are there. This can come under the, say, cybercrime against property. Or even if the time is there, so if any user pays for some specific time period for the login purpose, some unauthorized usages may be having the hacking of the paid hours, paid services, may be some change from one user to other user. So such type of the thefts are always possible. So whenever we talked about some say frauds which are related to your cards, maybe specifically to your credit cards, maybe these are related to specific applications or some losing or stealing of the cards are there, or maybe at the ATM level the frauds are carried out. Most of the time at the ATM stores it may be carried out because of the side channel attacks, which is another category what we have to study further. Or there may be some schemers available. What are the schemers? You can find out there are some schemers which are in the hard form, some small devices are there. Those small devices may read the information which is stored in the magnetic strips of your particular cards. It may identify, it may just check out the information, maybe of your three digit information, or maybe your 4 digit information, which is depending on your card. And normally the user is having this style that at the petrol pumps or at the say restaurants, people used to hand over the credit cards to the other people टू पे द बिल. तो एट दैट टाइम द स्कीमर्स कैन बी यूज एंड द इंफॉर्मेशन मे बी यूज टू स्टील द से डेटा और द मनी फ्रॉम द सेम क्रेडिट कार्ड आफ्टरवर्ड्स. सो अगेन द यूजर शुड नॉट बी हैविंग एनी कैजुअल अप्रोच. सम प्रिकॉशन शुड बी मेंटेन. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द ट्रेडमार्क एंड द वायलेशन ऑफ दिस वन. यू जस्ट वॉच दिस पर्टिकुलर इमेज. इन दिस इमेज द बिस्लरी बॉटल, मोस्ट ऑफ टाइम्स बिस्लरी इज वन ऑफ द वेल नोन से नोमेनक्लेचर और वेल नोन वेंडर इन द फील्ड ऑफ से मिनरल वाटर्स. बट इफ सम अदर वेंडर्स हु आर जस्ट ट्राइंग टू कॉपी बट नॉट एक्जैक्टली द सेम कॉपी मे हैव द सिमिलर नेम्स एंड ट्राई टू गेट द गुडविल ऑफ द बिस्लरी टू सेल डाउन देयर ओन मिनरल वाटर, देन पॉसिबली सच केस और अदर सिमिलर केसेस मे अपियर इन अंडर द नेम ऑफ द साइबर स्कॉटिंग. So cyber scouting will go for the just utilizing or selling or using the domain name with the intent of the profit from the goodwill of the some other's trademark. So that can be carried out with the stealing of the rights of the domain name or even the similarity of the domain name, and that can fool the user. So in that way again the user should maintain certain precautionary aspect to find out which is the legitimate one, which is the not the legitimate one. Against organization again there are number of crimes. Maybe unauthorized accesses are there, maybe because of the intruders maybe from the insider or the outsider. We have seen some of the crimes related to those. So most of the crimes are related by password sniffing. Maybe some denial of the services are there which can carry forward for the distributed denial of services. Some malwares are there which is specific introduction of the malwares to harm the system. Some email bombing are there. Some salami attacks are there. Some logic bombs are there. So even I should just talk about for the salami attack. I can say that it is having some insignificant financial alteration, but that will definitely cause some sizable fraud. For example, if bank charge the user as one paisa as one of the interest or other one of the payment, so one paisa is totally negligible for the user, the bank customer. So the customer just ignore about this particular amount. But if this amount is grouped or the cumulative amount of the say millions of the users, if we consider, then that will go for some significant amount, and that is considerable amount, and that particularly comes out for the data diddling, which is hand in hand attack. I can say that this data diddling will go for the altering the raw information or raw data just before the processing. So most of the time you are having some processing devices, maybe calculators, maybe computers. Again, coming with the example of the bank, if the bank is giving some interest and if that interest is slightly changed for the calculation purpose, and after calculation if that again maintained as it is. For example, if the bank is giving me interest, very minimal interest as the 5.043, and for the calculation purpose I am using this as the 04 with the 2 precision for the rounding of the data, then this will cause say significant difference in the calculation, the entire calculation, and that will lead to the salami attack itself. So such type of the things are there which can be carried out against organization. Continuing further for the attack against organization, some industrial spying is there because we can find out that there is a great competition in the industry. So if any one person from one company, if the person is entered into the other company because to steal the information, maybe it's a organized crime, whatever you can say, may get the information about the finance, maybe about the customer list, maybe about the marketing strategies, the know-hows, or even what exactly is the R&D going on in the specific organization. That information may be handed over to some other company, and such problems may initiate to have again the race in the market for those companies. Some intrusions are there. Okay, already we have talked about that. Then we are saying about this software piracy. Again, we have talked about the software piracy, maybe related to your copy down the genuine programs from one person to other person. Maybe it's a piracy of your thought process. Maybe your writing, maybe your ideaware, maybe your software. In that way, the piracy can be carried out. against society, you can say that the societal items are there. So if the crime is taken against the mass entity, the mass entity may be from the society. So it's a counterfeit currency notes are there, some fake postages are there, revenue stamps are there, or even fraud mark sheets may create a problem. Oh, it's a problem against the society. Some terrorism may get spread over disruptive activities or causing some social or ideological events are there. Most of the times we find that some religious activities may carry out, and the society, the pure people, or some say people who are not exactly involved in this activity may get harmed or may get some actions against them. So this may having some harms, and maybe intentional harms are there. Some webjackings are there. So even if the website is say I own some website, so I may lose the control of the website because of that if I lose the password, or if my password is getting hacked, then I may lose the control of the website. So that is the website or the webjackings are there. So against the society, if any crimes are carried out, many of the times these crimes may originate from the Usenet news groups. So news groups may carry or communicate some offensive or harmful information. That information may be inaccurate or may be inappropriate, and such inappropriate postings may harm, may tarnish certain individual identity. And that's why it is the responsibility of the user or the reader or the observer to take the proper precaution or use some common sense and judgment to give the justice to the information or the news itself. Whenever we talked about, most of the times we have talked about with the computer as a device with the narrow sense or the broader sense to commit the harm, or to use the computer as if it is the device for maintaining the incidents. But nowadays, again, the mobile devices, that is the Android or the Windows or even iPhones, are used for the maintaining the information or spreading the information or just storing the evidences for the purposes. And such handsets can be used to carry out some criminal activities. So if even any trespassing is there, some of the ways are there that if any mobile handset is to be identified, that from where it is originated, likewise the IP addresses what we have found for the computers within the networks, likewise we can find out some IMEI code, which are the International Mobile Equipment Identification Code, which are the 15 digit code. So out of these, if the first two digits are 35, then definitely with the confidence I can mention that this particular mobile device is from India itself. So some geographical areas and the SIM which are allocated to the users can be identified with this particular numbers, and those numbers can be utilized for further investigation, for the forensic investigations. Many of the cases you may recall back, these are associated for such type of the incidences. Now I'll talk about for some Trojans, and now I'm talking for the Trojans which are related to your mobile devices with the SMS categories itself. Say there is a person which is the normal or the casual, in a casual way, the person tries to download the movie player application, and that player application demands for some more permissions, and obviously a common person who is unaware of all details will go for giving or accepting the permissions. At the same time, the app automatically tries to install or send SMS text, and that SMS text may charge some money, and that money will get deducted directly from the payment of the that movie player or some phone bill or some text messages bill itself, and user is totally unaware of paying of the bill from his own pocket, from his or her own pocket. So Trojans, this type of the Trojans do not reproduce or any infection or do not self-replicate. That is the, this is the observation of the virus or the worm. It is not working like a virus or the worm, but Trojans must spread through some interactions, such as opening some email attachments or downloading or running some files through the internet itself. Though a demand for the network itself, Trojans can work on the system and make changes without having any connection to the network. Only the thing is that the steering of the information requires for the network availability. So in that way, the Trojans are working. But whatever are the methods, of course, there is a special group who is the expert group, who is authorized rather for the laws and the enforcement. There are certain investigations can be carried out. There are certain cyber acts are available for every possible nation. But being technical people, I can say that we are having, or we are just restricted towards certain technological measures. So we have seen some confidentiality measures are there, some authority measures are there, or even some system precautions are there. You can put some cryptography, signatures, firewalls or honeypots are there. So out of this one, if any forensics is to be considered, there are some hard devices or soft devices are there for the investigation purpose. The photo may give you idea about some of the devices. Those devices may get connected to your computer, may get connected to your, say, it will have certain replications, some reports. It will give you some reports about the times, about the memory utilization, or even other waveforms which are generated for the utilities while having the checks or the copies or the deletion of any of the information with your computer itself. So when we talk about the digital forensics and the lifestyle involved for this one, first of all, the requirement is that it should recognize the incidents, that is the forensic incidents, that is the criminal incidents rather, I should say. So there are, what is the requirement of the tools and the techniques and the search warrants are there, and whether the parties involved, these are authorized or not, this should be carried out in the first phase. The second phase goes for, once the incidence is recognized, the evidence should be identified. So identify or recognize the evidence and collect for those evidences. Once the evidences are collected, now the preservation comes in a picture. So secure evidences, or there should be some maintenance of the evidences in the secure manner. So integrity checks come in a picture. So preservation is the third phase, rather you can say. Once the preservation is there, it should be passed to the court for the examination purpose, or rather not to the court itself, but under the laboratory itself. If the examination is there, the evidences should be duplicated. The same evidence cannot be investigated as it is. The duplication is required, and while maintaining the duplication, the replication copy, the precaution is required. So duplication is one of the major factor what we require in the forensic analysis, and the recovery of the data is again the another aspect. Once the analysis is carried out for having the evidence, then the significance should be determined, and if any fragments of the data are there, those fragments, that particular data should be aligned for the reconstruction of the, say, legitimate or even meaningful data, and some conclusion should be drawn with this one. Some reports should be generated for the summarization of the conclusions, and if any requirement is there for the translation of the, say, local language, within the local language, then that translation should be carried out with the correct sense, and some conclusion should be explained to the parties. So it is said that whatever are the criminal activities takes place with the cyber, very few are reported, and out of those, very few are investigated. Out of those, very few are taken to the court, and very, very few are sentenced. Some solutions are carried out. Whatever the diagram I have given, this is not to the exact percentage of the whatever the classification we have made here, but it is just giving the sense that out of total cases which are actually taken place with the cyber and related devices, very few are sentenced and some conclusions are carried out. So it is the requirement of the day that people from technology and law should come together, and they should work together so that number of cases can be, say, investigated in a meaningful way. And you people are having a very good, say, future, or you can choose your career in such areas where your technology, your expertise will help to the other people. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.